Well, have you been even a little observant this morning, you may have noticed that a bunch of old guys have been up here talking to you about the soul. Like, we understand what it's all about and how to market to kids who we envision are going to be buying this car in droves. Well, that's true. However, we've had a secret weapon. Her name is Kayleen Ogden. Many of you have heard her last night in the hospitality suite. She has an amazing voice. She told me she's never lost her voice so far, so hopefully she'll be able to talk. She's with David and Goliath, our advertising agency. She was brought in to the Soul Project very early in our planning stages as to how to bring this vehicle to market in the United States. And through Kayleen's youth and expertise, we've been kind of schooled in what Gen Y is all about. Now, at this point of the presentation, I need to remind you, we're going to show you a video during Kayleen's presentation that we cannot have videotaped because I don't have the copyrights to this. So I have people back there that are going to remind you to kindly turn off your cameras or turn them away, and don't even audio record what's going on, if you don't mind, please. So without further ado, Kayleen, it's all yours.
Hello. So obviously, yes, I am younger. And I will be representing Gen Y for all of you guys out there. Let's take it away. So basically, we are not the typical Kia buyer. We are a bit younger and a little bit different in how we look at life and how we act, basically. So I'm just going to take you kind of through it, give you an idea of who we're trying to speak to. We are obviously younger. We were going for a target age around 23. These are people that have graduated college and not in college anymore. They are getting their first jobs. They're going into the real world. So these are just a few things. They're social, they're easygoing, positive, hardworking. Not the slacker Gen Y that people give us a bad rap for. So here's a few other faces of Gen Y besides me. Basically, don't forget that this age group is aging just like everybody else. So they do have younger families now. They're getting in the workforce. We're taking a bigger step into this economy. So don't forget about us. Basically, we're watching a lot of different things, but here's just a snapshot. Maybe it's some of the same stuff you watch. We're not that different. It ranges from drama to Colbert Report, Daily Show, Lost, anything that we find amusing or interesting. Mostly, though, the difference is going to be online. We grew up with technology. We know how to use it. We're constantly checking websites, updating status, getting our news from places like The Onion or Twitter, pretty much any way that we can get communication. So technology is really important. Most of us won't leave home without two devices, maybe three, iPod, cell phone, BlackBerry, iPhone, whatever. So we're going to be connected at all times. It's really not just if you're sitting in front of your computer. It's if you can hold something that can connect you to your friends or people that might be friends that you've never met, but they're friends online, we can talk to them. So as I said earlier, it's important to remember that we're between two different life stages. So concerts and parties and all of that is part of our life, but we're also networking. We're hanging out with coworkers. We're kind of between that life stage, and we're connected to our college friends, but also trying to make a way in the workforce as well. So these are just a few things that can define this generation as it relates to the car. The ability to personalize or customize is really important. Nobody wants something mass-produced. They want something that feels like their own, that acts as a reflection of them as well. And I think that's not a bad thing. It means that we want to be a little more unique, a little different, and that's just kind of the way it's going. So we also respond well to graphic, more of the visual than the written. So if you're going to look between an image and the written description of it, we're going to go to the vision first. So then we're going to go for the clean, simple imagery. Basically, it's quick and to the point. If we can get an idea of what we're doing quickly, it's going to be more effective. And then technology, as I said earlier, we were born with it. We didn't adapt it, so we're pretty good at it.